To the other big development, the controversy over the Kausar Nag Yatra is now snowballing into a major political fight. A day after Omar government's dramatic U-turn following pressure from the separatists, Kashmiri pundits have decided to hit the streets, demanding permission to carry out the Kausar Nag Yatra, which they are leading for the first time since the insurgency. Now, after the meet with the MOS PMO Jitendra Singh, he has actually sought a report from the Jammu and Kashmir government on the reasons behind the withdrawal of the order.
No, at the outset, I would like to state that it is our considered belief that there should be least amount of interference from the side of government in the matters of faith. And on the contrary, the government should rather try to facilitate such pilgrimages. Having said that, let me also hasten to add that somehow, fortunately, unfortunately, a message has gone out that the Yatra has been cancelled under some sort of extraneous considerations or pressures. I would not like to comment on that. We have received a memorandum which we will submit to the Honorable Home Minister and request him to take an appropriate view on it.
Well, Pooja Shaili, who's been following this story and the developments, joining us at this point. The U-turn is what has irked a lot of people, isn't it? And the Omar government will have to offer a very, very convincing answer, because they were laying out the red carpet for the Yatra. And soon after Syed Ali Shah Gilani and the separatists made noises, then they backtracked.
And certainly, Anand, what is important here and also very noticeable is that we've been running this story since morning, and there's been absolutely no response or clarification from the government in the state of Jammu and Kashmir. Generally, a chief minister, Umar Abdullah, who is so active on social media, knowing fairly well that this is such a sensitive issue and that the separatists have taken hold of the matter, they have threatened agitations across this, specifically the Srinagar Valley. Shutdown is in fact expected tomorrow. No word from the government as to why this Yatra that was first permitted and then cancelled without a written confirmation and clarification, because some of the pilgrims, what we are being told, had reached Kulgam, which is very close to the Kausar Nag area, which is the Aharbal Fall, and that suddenly they were informed that it has been cancelled. So as of now, they continue to protest. They have met the PMO MOS Jitendra Singh, who has in fact said that he will reach out to the Home Minister, and that if the reasons are not enough for the cancellation, the Yatra should be permitted. And considering it is a sensitive issue, the fact remains, did the Omar government really bow down to the pressure of the separatists, knowing fairly well that state elections are approaching in the next few months? So what really happened? Is it only a law and order situation or something else? The government needs to come out with at least one statement as to why suddenly the pilgrims from Kashmir, Kashmiri pilgrims, wanted to take a Yatra, were given an alternate route which absolutely did not make sense to them, and suddenly it appeared that there could be further problems. Right. Whether the separatists say it's environment damage or otherwise, what is the stand of the government is not clear. Back to you.
Pooja, just stay on with us. That question and that argument perhaps can stand defeated altogether. But before that, let's take a listen to what the Congress has to say, because the Congress party itself is speaking in different voices. While the Congress and the state in Jammu and Kashmir has opposed this move by Omar Abdullah, the Congress at the centre has backed the Omar government.
आज मुझे बड़ा दुख हुआ कि गवर्नमेंट ने इस यात्रा की परमिशन देने के बाद कल उनको रोक दिया, बंद कर दिया कि वो यात्रा नहीं ले जा सकते. कुछ एलिमेंट की वजह से जिन्होंने वहाँ पर मुखालफत शुरू की, मैं इसको स्ट्रांगली कंडेम करता हूँ, सख्त सख्त लफ्जों से मजम्मत करता हूँ और मांग करता हूँ कि गवर्नमेंट ऐसी यात्राओं को रोकने के बजाय उनको पूरी प्रोटेक्शन देकर ये यात्राएं चलाती रहे, ताकि वो भाईचारा. इन यात्राओं में सिर्फ एक किस्म के लोग नहीं जाते.
Well, my understanding is, and I really can't speak for the Kashmir government, but they say it is a security issue and that one route is available, another route is not available. Now, that is something that I think we will really have to see resolved in Kashmir. I don't know what position my party has taken in Kashmir, but obviously the safety and security of people is also important to us.
Well, that was the Congress. Now, let's take a listen to what the National Conference had to say.
There are concerns about established norms of pilgrimages, established routes and traditions, and there is absolutely no question of buckling under any pressure. The government's stand, as always, is and will be a stand bereft of any ideological, religious, or any hue that it is being attributed with.